As we understand each new language, we learn more about the way human beings communicate with one another.
Oh, look! It's an envelope. It has a letter inside. It's an invitation. Matt Hatter has been invited to a mad tea party. He's going to prove that language is madness. And the guest of honor is to be Dr. Linguistics.
A fish, whistle, gyre, and gimbal. It'd be right over.
My goodness. Tea and linguistics. What a curious combination.
The mad tea party is about to commence.
Who's coming?
Well, I've invited a cowboy from the Southwest,
a theatrical publicity man, and some other guests.
How do you do, Shorty?
Gimme, man.
Judy, this is Shorty Rogers, famous jazz trumpeter and composer.
Hey there, Judy.
How do you do?
Crazy.
Shorty, you're going to meet a very distinguished professor of linguistics.
Is this cat cool, square, or way out?
Well, I'm not sure that I follow you, but this should prove a very amusing encounter. They won't understand each other at all. Shorty, it is my great pleasure to introduce to you the very distinguished Dr. Linguistics. Doctor, this is Shorty Rogers.
I'm very happy to make your acquaintance, Doctor.
Skin me, man.
Man, you're really weathered. What's the bet here?
Well, a hat here has been trying to bug me on this ABC jazz. Crazy made the scene, man, crazy.
Hey, you're a real live aspirin. Well, I have to split now. So long.
Keep cool.
They seem to understand each other, but I couldn't.
Maisie too. Me either.
Well, Wadley meets my next guest.
Oh, Dr. L, I'd like you to meet a theatrical publicity man.
How do you do?
Hi.
Looks as if you already have a story.
Yep, here's my lead. Tongues wag as wags gag, but hot hat cools as Doc clicks on rhetoric tricks.
Well, that just about ballpoints the hats, chap.
Like a fat bat. Well, I gotta run now, Doc. This bash is a bop.
Some sock yarks packed in that flax cracks.
Saps, cracks, bandersnatch to me.
You're right, they do understand each other. Perhaps this next guest will confuse him.
Enjoying yourself?
Well, now, I don't want to sound like I raised on sour milk, but I just can't drink enough of this yellow gargle to get a talking low. You see, these doings give me buck fever. I get my spurs all tangled, and I'm just plain old hogtied when it comes to making chin music with a pack of strangers.
Well, Dr. Linguistics?
Well, it was all quite simple. He said he wasn't mouthy, he's fresh out of tongue oil, this wingding shortens his stake rope, makes him feel like he's got his leg tied up.
Say, partner, you sat in my lingo. You'll do to ride the river with.
Well, I gotta roll my wheel.
So long, Doc.
So long, amigo. Him and me's made of the same leather.
Well, so much for linguistics. Now, do let us have some tea. Judy, after that variety of verbal vocalizing, surely you would agree that language is a mixed-up mess.
But Dr. Linguistics didn't seem to think the tea party was so mad.
No, actually, I thought it was quite sensible.
Sensible? With everyone speaking a different language?
Different dialect, if you please. Now, these dialects and occupational vocabularies are what make any language interesting, colorful. They're part of our humor. They're also the subject of scholarly research.
Well, Dr. Linguistics, I'm afraid that you and I are not made of the same leather.
Well, thanks for the tea and linguistics. It was very pleasant. Judy, would you care to join me in a little research project in American dialect geography?